Hey there, my name is Nicole, and I'm a systems implementation consultant at SMV. And in this video, I'll be talking about some highlights that ClickUp came out with in 2023. So stay tuned for an end of year recap. All right, let's get into it. So first thing I want to touch on is the new and improved ClickUp homepage. So we're used to seeing just a set homepage, not much customization, but now we have these widgets and we're able to customize, shift them around, determine exactly what we want to see on our individual homepage. So if I come here and click edit layout, I'm able to move things around and adjust accordingly. And I can also manage the cards that I'm seeing on my homepage. So I can decide exactly what items I want to pull in. So I can see recent, so a list of all ClickUp objects and locations I've recently viewed. I can see my agenda for visualizing tasks on different calendars all in one place, etc. So I'm able to determine exactly what things I want to see on my homepage, which is a really awesome feature. Next thing I want to touch on is the new and improved sidebar. So in ClickUp 3.0, we have this new sidebar on the left-hand side where we can easily access our inbox notifications, we can access our docs, dashboards, and more. So I can access my whiteboards, my pulse, my goals directly from the sidebar. And our inbox is structured a little bit differently. So I can see my important notifications here, which are things that directly pertain to me, and any other notifications that I should be made aware of. So it's really easy to navigate through these notifications and take action on these notifications directly through inbox. And docs, same thing. We have a really great docs hub now, which is a new feature as of this year. We can easily see any recent docs, favorite docs, any docs created by me. And then here I'm able to see a list of all docs that I have access to. And then I can also narrow those down based on certain criteria. So a really great new docs hub. Then at the space and folder level, so I'll go into my operations space now, we now have this overview feature within all spaces and folders. So here I can see an overview of everything that's a part of that space or folder. So here I can see anything I've recently accessed within the space. I can see any docs that are connected to this location, which is really awesome. I can also really easily drag and drop in attachments to be included in this resources section. Then scrolling down, I can see any folders that I have as a part of the space and also any lists. So a really great way of seeing a high-level overview of that space or that folder. And then I'll go into this marketing folder, and you can see it has a very similar structure. So recent, docs, and resources, and then all lists that are a part of that folder. So really easy to see that higher-level view of those spaces and folders. Then we have a really awesome new feature that came out near the end of 2023, which is called task types. So not only can you have a task in ClickUp now, but you can create customized tasks. So you can have leads, you can have contacts, you can have projects, and you can designate those within your ClickUp workspace. So here, if I'm coming to add task, I can click this dropdown, and here I'm able to see all my different task types. So of course I can still create tasks, but I can also create milestones. I can create collectives, contacts, documents, groups, leads, and those are just the ones that I've created. But if I come here and click manage, I can see all of my task types and I'm able to create new ones and manage my list of types. So really great feature because not everything that we want to put in ClickUp is necessarily a task. Then another amazing feature that came out this year is our new and improved custom field manager. So if we come up here to this quick action menu, scroll down to the bottom, we have this custom field manager. I'll click in, and here I can easily see all the custom fields that I use throughout my entire ClickUp workspace, which is amazing. So right now they're being grouped by field type, so I can see all my checkbox fields, all my date fields, etc. I can also group them by location type, in which case I'm seeing everything that lives on the space level, the list level, etc. And I'm also able to filter down from there. I can create new fields directly from this manager, and I can search for fields as well. Then right now, obviously I'm looking at these custom fields from the full workspace level, but then I can also hone in on specific locations and see what lives in those locations. So nothing on my technical support space, but I do have some living on the list level. So I'm able to see those here and easily manage those from one central location. Next up is automations. So now, wherever you create an automation, whether it's at the space level, the folder level, the list level, wherever, you can add an automation, and you're able to take that automation and duplicate it into a different area within your ClickUp workspace, which is an amazing new feature, especially if you're using a lot of automation within your workspace. So I can go right here to click duplicate, and I have the option to duplicate it either in my current location, or I can duplicate it into another location. So if I click this, I'm taken to a full menu of every space, folder, list, et cetera, within my ClickUp workspace, and I'm able to add that automation to one of those areas really easily. Next thing I want to touch on is dashboards. So ClickUp dashboards is one of my personal favorite features, and ClickUp this year has made it really easy to drill down into those specific dashboards even more than we were able to in the past. So here I have an operations dashboard, and I have this pie chart showing me a breakdown of all the different statuses within my operations space and what percentage of tasks are living within those statuses. So here I can click in, you know, I can see there are 46 tasks with the status to do. Also, I can see that they're 55.42%, and I can do the same for all of my different status types. But now I'm able to drill down even further, and instead of just looking at it from that bird's eye view, which is still really great, I can click into one of these segments, and I can drill down and see exactly what's making up that segment of my chart. So I can see I have 5 tasks within that interview scheduled status. I'm able to see some information about those tasks, and I can also click directly into those tasks from that dashboard. So I think that's a really great addition to get even more insights out of your dashboards. And lastly, we have to talk about AI. AI has been a huge new addition to so many project management tools this year, and ClickUp is one of them. So I'll show a couple of my favorite AI features that are now a part of this platform. So within every task, you're able to use AI to automatically suggest and create subtasks. So I can click suggest right here. And ClickUp has suggested these 4 subtasks for me that could be connected to this task. And they all check out because this is part of my hiring pipeline. So we have confirm interview date, prepare interview questions, set up interview panel, and review candidate's application. I think all 4 of those make sense for this task. So I'm going to go ahead and create those. And then ClickUp will create them for me. And all I have to do now is input some information associated with those subtasks. So really awesome feature here. Then in the activity section, I also have an AI option where I can generate a summary of everything that's happened in relation to this task. So I'll click in. And there I can get a high-level summary that I'm able to copy, put in the task description, send to someone via Slack, whatever I want to do with that summary. I can just copy and paste it really easily, or I can try again and see if AI will spit out any additional information. And then lastly, I can generate a progress update, and I can do that either for today, yesterday, this week, etc. So I can choose my time frame for the status update, and I can click to generate. So let's say last 30 days. And there we go, we got a summary. So these are some really great AI tools that you can use really easily within your ClickUp workspace. And I highly recommend it because AI is only going to get more popular as 2024 progresses. I hope these updates from 2023 got you excited to use ClickUp in a more efficient way. So stay tuned for even more exciting updates coming in 2024.